Hello everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. Now in the last part we finished off the final tower for level 5, so it's about time to start moving on, maybe clear out a few more of these guys which you see running around here. But before we do that, I wanted to spend another episode showcasing some of the new items we picked up in the meantime, as well as highlighting some of the older ones which I haven't really shown you properly yet. So let's have a look at our list here. We've, in the meantime, we filled out our list. We've got at least one of every single item in the game, so we will be able to look at the functionality of each of them. The spectacles we've already looked at. The red potions are pretty obvious. Lamps, of course, we've seen extensively in the past videos. We have looked at the black onyx and the fire crystal before. Although I will show you a little bit more about those in a few minutes. The metal is pretty much covered. The hourglass is the first one, which is kind of new and pretty exciting. So let's attack this guy. And as you know, myconids are pretty strong, so they are a good monster to test this stuff with. So a myconid. Normally, it would do us a lot of damage. We could, of course, use our magic to take them all out and avoid getting hit that way. But let's say we want to kill the final myconid because he's got a very valuable item that we really want, but he's too strong for us to attack normally. We can use our hourglass, which freezes them in place, and then we can just stab them. It drops their agility to zero, I believe, which is why we get instant kills on each of them, and it also prevents them from fighting back. So yeah, you can't really ask for anything better than that when taking on these guys. So yeah, definitely very much worthwhile. Oops, I think I might have made a little mistake in killing them. No, okay, there's still one left. Okay, so that's the hourglass. Pretty useful, especially because, yeah, it basically lets you take out monsters that normally you wouldn't be able to. Next, we have winged boots and mantle. I'll show those in a second. First, I want to show you the demon's ring. Now, the demon's ring I told you about before I felt was maybe a little bit useless, but actually I was completely wrong about that. See these guys? They are the aggressive type, so they move straight for me. If now I use my demon's ring, I become invisible, and they won't be able to find me, which means they will run around more or less aimlessly. And similarly to the hourglass, they won't be able to counterattack when you're invisible, so I can just walk among them and be completely safe. So actually very useful indeed for taking out strong monsters as well. Let me just wait until it runs out to showcase our next item. Come on. Yep, there we go. Now let's move on from the demon's ring, the balance we've seen, the pendant we've seen, the candle. Now the candle is another item that I used to think was pretty useless, and I still think it is pretty useless. It changes you into a skeleton. Which means the enemies can still see you, but they cannot hurt you. At least not with normal attacks. I think magic attacks can still hurt you. So again, useful for avoiding strong monsters. The downside to the candle is that you cannot use your melee attacks, so there's no way for me to kill these guys except by magic now. And that's the reason it's kind of useless, because I could have killed them with magic anyway. So yeah, the candle is a little less useful, but it can still be good, I guess, if you want to get past some enemies or, yeah, something like that. Let's see, what else? So candle. Okay, well, there's the ruby, which is pretty straightforward. It doubles your strength for a short amount of time. Same goes for the brown potion, only this applies to intelligence. Doubles your intelligence temporarily. Then there's the mirror, which does the same for agility. Also useful for certain cases, but yeah, maybe not used too much. And finally, of course, we've got the mirror, bottle, which doubles your charisma. I'll show you quick. We've got keys here for about 1100 gold each. After we use our bottle, it drops down to 750. And it applies to healing and stuff like that as well, so yeah, it can be very useful indeed. Okay guys, as I was talking about before, let's take a look at these other guys, which are useful mostly in the overworld map. The first of which is the winged boots, which allows you to fly. So let's say I drop down this hole and I get stuck down here, which is absolutely very possible. There would really be no way to get out of here other than to use the winged boots and fly straight up. So you can see we can just move through the air. Still can't move up through these guys, but yeah. If you ever fall down somewhere where you can't get out, the wing boots are your friends. Now, okay, so let's say we actually did get stuck down here and there is no way to get out and we don't have any more boots. Let me show you real quick. First of all, we can use a candle, become a skeleton, become invulnerable to these guys. Now, as you can see, magic attacks still work, so yeah, skeletons a little less useful, but maybe for some cases, like these Myconids, which have a very strong physical attack, I can easily just go past them now. And finally, these guys. Now let's say I get stuck down here, and as you can see there's no way out except through this block, and we can't use our Madoc in this case, because Madocs dig down, and we're at the bottom of the level, so we can't dig past here. Now what I could do is use my mantle, which is an item that lets you pass through walls. Oh, actually it doesn't work here. I guess these walls are too low down, and you can't actually use them here. Okay, that sucks. So, yeah, we'd be stuck down here. Oh well. Let me just reboot real quick. And I'll show you the mantle in a slightly more convenient place. Okay, so this is a good place to show you. So let's say we went in here, we got tricked by this castle. We can't actually go in anywhere, and there's no way out. Now we could use Madocs, of course. But let's say we've run out of Madocs. In that case, we use our mantle. And the mantle allows you to walk through these blue walls and even use them as ladders, just like you're seeing here. Fall down here, we can just move through here, or we could just move back up through here. Works on blue walls, works on these stalagmites as well. It doesn't work on these blue and yellow walls. Those are, yeah, you can't use your Madocs on them, you can't use your mantle on them either, so there's no way to go through here. Okay, so that's pretty much all the items covered now, I think. Yep, that's all of them. So, as you can see, pretty much every item has a use. Maybe some of them are a little bit less useful than others. Stuff like the candle, I tend never to really apply in the actual game. Rubies, I don't usually use. Brown potions, that sort of thing. Mirrors, sometimes, but very rarely. But yeah, there's definitely situations where each of them is useful. Now, let's take another look at the Black Onyx first. I want to get back up, so oops. Let's use another mantle to go back up to the top of the level. Oh, and mantles even let you pass through these guys, so yeah. Mantles are very useful indeed. Okay, this is the entrance to the next level, to level 6. Let me get in there real quick. Oh, and before I go on, spoiler alert, if you don't want to see anything from the upcoming levels, then this is the time to turn off. Okay, so I'm up to level 6 now, and let me get my Black Onyx out. I just wanted to show you real quick what level 10 looks like. So we'll use the Black Onyx to get up to level 7, level 8, level 9. We're stuck. And finally level 10. So this is the dreaded level 10, the final level in the game. We got, as you can see, pretty insanely powerful monsters. 437,000 hit points, and that's by no means the strongest one. Even our extremely powerful Tilda spell has a hard time killing this guy. And as you can see, a single hit will easily kill us 10 times over almost. So yeah, these guys are much too strong for us right now, but I just wanted to show you a little bit of what level 10 looks like. I think the spiral thing leads to the final tower. Yeah, I think that's it, in the middle there. Protected by strong, strong creatures. And let me just show you real quick, this is the final tower. We cannot go in yet, because we don't have all the crowns yet, so there's no way in for us right now. Clearly there's no way, no convenient way out of here. So, yeah. So there's, yeah, there's no no real way to do anything here, significant here yet. I just wanted to show you a little bit of what this looks like and how strong the creatures are we have to fight here. Just for a laugh, let's grab the Demon's Ring and attack one of these guys and see if we can even damage them. I don't think so. Oh, well, actually, yeah, we can. I guess our halberd is strong enough to do a little bit of damage. But of course, without the Demon's Ring, we would instantly die to these guys. Our Tilt spell works a little bit better. But even that has a tough time killing them. Just want to see what item he drops. See a mirror, so not really worth wasting all our precious items on. In any case, I just wanted to give you a quick look at the upcoming levels and show you a little bit what kind of stuff are we facing in the future. Clearly this is going to be problematic for us right now, but once we hit the proper level, then this is going to be a lot easier than we have it right now. Okay guys, a little bit of a bonus episode here. Thanks for watching again, and in the next part we'll be taking on level 6. I'll see you then.